हाई ऑस्मोटिक कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, ऑस्मोटिक कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ के सी एल, पोटासियम क्लोराइड, ओके, ऑफ के सी एल, वेयर दे आर मेंटेनिंग इन देयर सेल्स, ओके, सो दे मेंटेन हाई ऑस्मोटिक कंसंट्रेशन ऑफ के सी एल इन देयर सेल्स, ओके. नाउ दिस बैक्टीरिया कैन बी लाइज्ड, लाइज्ड मीन्स कैन बी डैमेज्ड व्हेन NaCl concentration fall below 10%. This also you have to remember. So these halophiles can be lysed when NaCl concentration lies below 10%. Okay, when NaCl concentration, what happens, lies below 10%. Now, here example is what? Halococcus. Halococcus. Halobacterium. Okay, so these are the examples of halophiles. Now, sometime also question asking ki at what concentration they are growing very fast. So these grow well in a medium containing 25 to 30% NaCl concentration. Okay, so these can grow well in 25 to 30% NaCl concentration of medium. Okay, so what is that? 25 to 30% of medium that containing this NaCl concentration, in that condition they are growing well. Okay, and when they are damaging, when below 10% concentration raised. Okay, so first we seen methanogens, next we seen halophiles, and the third type of archaebacteria is thermoacidophiles. So come on that. So third type is thermoacidophiles. Third type is what? Thermoacidophiles. Now, thermo means temperature, acido means acid, and philes mean affinity. So those are bacteria which is having affinity with high temperature and high acidic medium. So what we can say, they are capable of tolerating high temperature as well as high acidity. So these are capable of tolerating high temperature and high acidic medium. Okay, high temperature and high acidic medium they are tolerating. Okay, and that's why named thermoacidophiles, and hence known as what they are knowing as, that's why known as thermo acidophiles. Okay, now these openly found in hot water. Okay, these oftenly found in hot water springs where temperature is as high as 80 degree centigrade and pH is as low as 2. Okay, so these are found in, these are found in hot water springs where temperature is as high as 80 degree centigrade and pH is as low as 2, means highly acidic and highly temperature they can withstand. Okay, they can tolerate. Okay, now these methanogens, sorry, these thermoacidophiles, they are doing what? They are oxidizing sulfur to sulfuric acid. So these thermoacidophiles oxidize sulfur to sulfuric acid, S2SO4. Okay, sulfuric acid. So these doing what? Thermoacidophiles oxidize sulfur to sulfuric acid under which condition? Under the presence of oxygen. So under aerobic condition. Under aerobic condition. Okay, so these oxidize thermoacidophiles under aerobic condition. Okay, and what happens if medium becomes anaerobic? If medium becomes what? Anaerobic. In that condition, what happens? Sulfur, what happens? Changed into sulfur, H2S, hydrogen sulfide. So next we have to come on. Under anaerobic condition, under anaerobic condition, thermoacidophiles, acidophiles changed sulfur into H2S, hydrogen sulfide. Okay, they are changing into hydrogen sulfide. Now here example is, what are the examples are there? Thermoplasma are there. So for example, thermoplasma, thermoproteus. Okay, so these are the bacteria, thermoacidophiles. Okay, now since they are chemically oxidized and making their energy for their organic food, that's why it is known as chemosynthetic in nature. Okay, hence these are all known as, what they are known as? Chemosynthetic. Chemosynthetic in nature. Already we discussed why aerobic condition, hydrogen, sulfur to sulfuric acid, and here sulfur to hydrogen sulfide in anaerobic conditions. Okay, so now we discussed what archaebacteria and their types. Now come on next, that is eubacteria. In under Monera, two types of bacteria we already discussed. One is archaebacteria and their types we discussed. Now come on next, that is eubacteria. So come on that. eubacteria. Okay, now eu means what? Eu means true. Eu, this is a Latin word that means true. So it is also known as true bacteria. It is also known as true bacteria. Okay, it is also known as what? True bacteria. This eu bacteria also known as true bacteria. Now this contain rigid cell wall, either flagellum or without flagellum. So it is mostly contain rigid cell wall with or without flagellum. Okay, so maybe flagella they are having or may not be flagella they are having. Okay, now we already know that a cyanobacteria. So cyanobacteria also comes under this eu bacteria. So cyanobacteria, or that is also known as blue green algae, also comes under this group. Okay, so cyanobacteria also coming under this group. Now we will see that what are the structure of eu bacteria. So we have to see in that structure of eu bacteria. Structure of eu bacteria. Okay, so what are the structures that this contain, that we have to see. Okay, so first we have to make one rough diagram that you can understand what are the components they are containing. Okay. Now, this is the structure that is known as cell wall. Okay, this is the structure that is known as cell wall. Okay, this is the tough structure that is known as capsule. Now, inner to cell wall, one more layer is there, this is cell membrane. Okay, so what we seen, cell wall, cell membrane, capsule, and inside that irregular structures are there, that is known as incipient nucleus. It is incipient nucleus. Okay, now you are seeing that this cell membrane, one finger like structures are present, enfolding of plasma membrane is there. This is known as mesosome. Okay, this is known as mesosome, where a respiration takes place. Okay, now on cell wall, some hair-like growth structures are coming that helps in attachment with surface or making helping in colony. So this is known as pili. Okay, this is known as pili. And here these are containing what? Flagellum. Okay, flagellum they are having. So this is the structure of bacteria that we are seeing. Okay, if you will see that, so by structure, this bacterial structure, okay, by these we will see if structure. So this bacteria looking what? Very simple, but they are having very complex in behavioral. Okay, so what I told, just the structure of bacteria is very simple, but the behavior of bacteria is very complex. What I told, the structure of bacteria is very simple, but the behavior of bacteria is very complex. Now this bacteria contain complex cell envelope. What I told, bacteria contains complex cell envelope, cell covering. Okay, so this bacteria contains what? Complex cell envelope. Okay, now these contain a three-layered structure, and what are those that we have to see? That these contain these contain three-layered structure. Okay, these contain what? Three-layered structure. And what is that? Outermost is glycocalyx. So first is outermost is glycocalyx. Okay, so outermost is glycocalyx. Now these glycocalyx, if they are having thick layered, glycocalyx having two layered, one is thick and hard, that is known as capsule that we seen in the figure, and one is thin, okay, and known as slime layer. So what we can say, glycocalyx containing two layered structure, hard or thick is capsule and thin. Okay, thin is what? Slime layer. Okay, so thin is slime layer. Now, second structure. First, what we seen? Outermost. Then, next one was cell wall. In the bacterial structure, we seen that. Next was cell wall. And third one is cell membrane. Third one is cell membrane. So these protective layer are three. One is glycocalyx, if thick or hard capsule, thin or loose. Thin or loose, that is known as slime layer. Second is cell wall and third is cell membrane. Okay. Now, these three layered structure together known as single protective unit of bacteria. What I told? These combinedly known as single protective unit. So this you have to give attention, that single protective unit of bacteria contains structure. So what are the structures they are having? Glycocalyx, cell wall and cell membrane. And glycocalyx containing what? Capsule and slime layer. If thick and hard, capsule. Thin and loose, slime layer. So these you have to give attention always, that single protective unit of bacteria containing three layered structures that contain glycocalyx, cell wall and cell membrane. Okay, so one by one we will see that what are the function, what is the characteristic features. So come on, first glycocalyx. Glycocalyx. Already we know this is what? Outermost protective layer. Glycocalyx is what? This is outermost protective layer that contain structure. So it is outermost protective layer which contains thick and hard layer known as capsule and thin and loose layer known as slime layer. Okay, so one is known as what? Capsule, and one is known as what? Slime layer. Okay, now sometime question asking, this formation of glycocalyx takes place with the help of. So this glycocalyx is formed by the helping of what? Cell membrane. So what we can say, formation of glycocalyx is formation of glycocalyx is done by the help of cell membrane. Okay, So here no role of cell wall to formation of glycocalyx. So who is helping for formation of glycocalyx? So that is cell membrane. Okay. Now, sometime question asking that capsule is made up of or slime layer is made up of. Okay. So capsule is made up of polysaccharide and polypeptide. Capsule is made up of polypeptide and polysaccharides. Okay, so capsule is made up of what? Polypeptide and polysaccharide. But slime layer is made up of what? Only polysaccharide. Whereas slime layer is made up of polysaccharides only. Polysaccharides only. Okay. And since polypeptide and polysaccharides making capsule, that's why it is hard and tough. Okay. Thick. Now, this glycocalyx doing what? They protects from the WBC. White blood cells is there and also help in colony formation. So glycocalyx having what benefit? Glycocalyx protects bacteria from WBC. WBC means white blood corpuscles. Okay, and also helping and also helps in colony formation. Okay, and also help in what? Colony formation. Okay, now this glycocalyx, sometime question asking which are the components of the bacteria that protects from WBC. So you have to remember this. This is what? This is the glycocalyx of bacteria that protects from WBC. Okay. Now, next layer is what? Cell wall. So come on that. Cell wall is that. So next is cell wall. Now, this cell wall is mainly made up of peptidoglycan. So what we can say? Bacterial cell wall is mainly made up of what they are made up of what? Mainly what I told? Peptidoglycan. So bacterial cell wall is mainly made up of peptidoglycan. Okay, now we already know two type of bacteria are there, gram positive, gram negative. Okay, so in a gram positive bacteria, cell wall is single layered and thick. So what we can say? In gram positive bacteria, cell wall is single and thick. Okay, and another type is what? Okay, another type is gram negative. So thick due to presence of lipids. Now here what happens? Lipids, they are having, but mostly these lipids presence having, but they are mingle with peptidoglycan. So what we can say, mostly the presence of peptidoglycan along with mingling with lipids. So lipids quantity is very less. So what we can say, due to presence of lipids in very few quantity, but mostly what happens, mostly peptidoglycan are present. Okay, now, but in gram negative bacteria, cell wall is double layered due to presence of high quantity of lipids. Due to presence of what? High quantity of lipids and lipopolysaccharide. So what is the difference between these two? Here this is single and thick. Why? Because some mingling of lipids are there along with peptidoglycan, but mostly what happens, mostly they contain peptidoglycan. But in a gram negative bacteria, they are having double layered. Okay, why? Because high quantity of lipids and polysaccharides both are there, means they are made up of what? Lipopolysaccharides. Okay, now sometime I seen a question, what do you mean by L form bacteria? Okay, so we have to see that, what is L form bacteria? L form, or it is also known as a Lister form of bacteria. Now, what happens? Bacteria containing cell wall, if this cell wall is dissolved or removed, okay, if this is dissolved or removed artificially by the help of lysozyme, then bacteria are called L form or Lister form. Okay, so what I told, bacterial cell wall is dissolved or removed with the help of lysozyme. This you have to remember, with the help of lysozyme artificial. Mix the bacteria L form or known as what? Lister form of bacteria. Okay, so artificially removing cell wall with the help of lysozyme known as L form. Okay, now, so second protective layer, what we see, cell wall. Now third one is cell membrane. Cell membrane or plasma membrane or biomembrane. Now, this bacterial cell membrane is made up of lipoprotein as eukaryotes. Okay, what is that? As eukaryotic membrane. So, bacterial okay, this bacterial membrane or cell membrane is made up of cell membrane is made up of what? Lipoprotein. As eukaryotic cell membrane made. Eukaryotic cell membrane forms. Okay, so these are the protective unit that contained in eubacteria. Okay, now one more thing are there in the eubacteria, that is cytoplasm. So next, come on, cytoplasm. Now this bacterial cytoplasm lacking cell